Ladies and gentlemen, I'm very happy to be here today. TEDx is such a great format and event format for spreading ideas. And I would like to thank the organizers for the invitation and for the chance to present my idea or my dream to you right now. My name is Christian Bauer. I'm the CEO of a creative agency, and I will talk about energy for everyone. I got an education as an electronics engineer and was very much fascinated by computer science, so I started to work as a programmer. I continued in the area of computer graphics and in particular into the area of 3D real-time computer graphics. I was active in this area for 12 years, and two of the 12 years I spent in Silicon Valley, where I learned a lot. So my first phase in my business life was 12 years of ICT. Then I changed my area of activity into cultural management, so that's what I still do mainly today. And I was very happy to enrich my activities. I did big events. These pictures are pictures of my last event. It was for the biggest European media corporation. I was the art director. We had, for this event, we made a very special setting. We created a virtual space where people presented, and the reason to get into this area actually was Austrian artist André Heller, who was very much of an inspiration for me. And in 98, I joined his team, and I worked since then with him and for him. And I was also the project manager for Crystal Worlds. You may have heard of, or the Austrians at least know about it. It is a very successful touristic destination, attracting people from all over the world. And we have built crazy rooms. We are fascinating people. I have learned in these second 12 years to inspire people and to entertain people. One of the many projects we did was the bidding, final presentation of the bidding for Germany in the year 2000 for the FIFA World Cup 2006. To the surprise of many people, our presentation made Germany to win the bid, and therefore we did a lot of projects. I have built. I am maybe the biggest project manager of large soccer balls. Here you see one. This one traveled around the world. We built another one, who went around in Germany. And what I learned in this time, so I came from ICT. I learned how to present. I learned how to make objects, rooms, installations interesting to people. But then, after it, ironically enough, it was 12 years. Again, I changed my area of business slightly because I recognized that entertaining and inspiring people is valuable, but there's maybe for the things to come for us, there's one technology which is key, and this is renewable energies. So with three partners, I built a power plant in Austria, in Carinthia. It has 1 megawatt. And the speciality, also there I implemented creativity, is it's a fence-free, open power plant that is generating additional benefits. So it's not only for the people who build and run the facility, but it is for the citizens. They should get attracted by solar energy, they should go there. So we have a lot of flowers there, we have bees who are spreading the seeds, we have a viewing platform, etc. And so this was about renewable energy, and then one interesting fact is, I researched how many people do have energy, and we have heard in the talk before that it is about 1.6 billion My research or the studies I found was that 1.3 to 1.8 billion people have absolutely no access to power, 1.6 to 2.4 have no regular access to power, and maybe the most astounding number is 4 billion people on this planet have no stable electricity. So I was thinking on what we could do about that. And particularly if you hear these big numbers, you can say this is a scandal or this is representing the uneven distribution of resources on the planet. But you can also say how interesting, this is probably one of the biggest markets you can deal with. There's a lot of energy on the planet, so I don't want to go into detail about the non-renewable energies, but how can you satisfy, how can you do something against I need a new remote control, it's not working. What energies can we use for that purpose? There's a lot of cynical things going around, and I think that the solution is very clear. We have the sun, we have the wind. We have seen in the presentation before that in fact sun and wind that we have, and we have much more renewable energies. Imagine simply the energy of the waves of all the oceans on this planet. And so it is very clear that we have to go into this direction. And I don't think I have to convince anyone in the room here why it is good to go into that direction. Is it because it is clean? Is it because it makes no noise? Is it because it is not dangerous? So if we have the conclusion that we need renewable energies to supply the other half of the planet with energy, what can we do? My idea was to build a very simple, small unit that is using several batteries and that gets the energy from photovoltaic modules as well as from wind turbines. And I was inspired by thinking about this, by the One Laptop Per Child project by Nicolas Negroponte, Professor Negroponte from the Media Lab. The One Laptop Per Child, I don't know whether you remember, has changed a lot of things in the computing business, because exactly when the One Laptop Per Child computer came into the market, companies like Acer, etc., coincidentally brought the netbook. So right now you can buy a computer for €300, and before the netbooks came, the typical price tag for a notebook was about €1,000. So this has changed the industry in my opinion, and now going to the energy device, I called it SolPack, it's a very easy name like solar package. What do we have to do now? Because obviously we want to invent something like what the Swatch was for the watch industry. So a very, I have written down, it is three attributes that come into mind about it. The three attributes are, it has to be low cost, it has to be robust, and it has to be simple. These are the main attributes of such a device. If we look at the components, now one obvious, energy generation component are photovoltaic modules. There are many modules existing today. You may have heard that the prices are going down, so this is working for this idea. There are foldable panels, there are cheap panels, respectively. There are also flexible. This remote control is. Okay. There are thin film, rollable photovoltaic modules, and the second energy source obviously is wind. There are meanwhile many wind devices. They go down. If you buy for yourself a little wind turbine, you may get it for €300, €400, €500. I know a company and founded a very interesting invention. They are using PET bottles, you know, the Coca-Cola PET bottles, and they cut the bottles and form out of altogether five bottles. They make one wind turbine, and they say that they can achieve about 30% of the energy efficiency of the existing professionally built wind turbines. So this is not as efficient, but the point is that such a wind turbine is made out of trash. So the effective costs for such a recycled wind turbine, it's just, I don't know, maybe a few euro. If we look again at the device, if we talk about battery technology, I think the best battery technology is not sophisticated deep charging lead gel batteries, but it is car batteries, because car batteries you have all over the world. There are known ways how you, in a clean way, can recycle car batteries. And it is also smart, because if you ship this, the heaviest part is the battery, and it's better to ship it like in developing countries, such a device without a battery, because you have much less costs. So I started working in this area, and I built myself such a solution, because I thought if I cannot only talk smart about it, I have to work in this area. I bought myself a solution for 3,000 euro to make first experiments. You see this, it's on my terrace in my Vienna apartment. And I then continued, found new components, and came down to 650. These are like the lowest cost achievable components. Mostly you buy them directly in China from Chinese manufacturers. It works. It is nice. It is delivering 400 watt approximately. So 400 watt is enough to charge your mobile phone, to charge your notebook, and maybe in a hot country you may have a fan that you will run with this device. Respectively, you have an energy efficient lighting situation. However, the target would be, I think, that if we go the next step and we can build this in a larger volume, this would be maybe 10,000 pieces, maybe as a first rollout we can make 10,000 pieces, I think we would come down to 300 euro. This is an approximate prediction. Now, the question is, how do we get to the people? How do we get into the market? Idea number one is that, first of all, the development obviously needs a sponsor, some sponsoring research, whatever institution that makes it available that the first rollout can be, so first the research is being done, and then the first 10,000 pieces are being built. We are happy to have some substantial interest from renowned organizations. However, we are still looking. We do need additional support. I right now have about a 50% financing situation, which is nice, but we need a little bit more. The point is to reach the people in developing countries. Obviously, the people are not able to, I mentioned before, around 300 euro. They cannot afford this, but the idea is, like in the One Laptop Per Child project, that it is not the people who buy it, but it's the governments. Because government typically takes tax and is building infrastructure with the tax. Now, if you think about a developing country, think of a region like Darfur. Darfur has 2 million people living there on an area as big as Germany. So you probably can imagine that the standard electrification of Darfur is completely unthinkable, unfeasible. But what is possible, if you have these tiny little units that you put into the household and you put the solar modules on the roof, this may work, because you equip every, village with such a system, and you do not need standard electrification. Of course, these systems would also be offered to individuals. My idea was that these people support, because it's very cheap. They pay two, get one, and they support the project. Also in developed nations, I don't have to tell you, there's a lot of demand. I just, with my kids, I was on a little island in Greece. And I mean, there are many places, islands, remote huts in forests, on the mountains, etc., that people also in industrialized nations need such a device. But there's another issue. And this issue is that you cannot just give people energy. This is, I spoke with a lot of people who do the development work and development aid, and they said, no, you have to achieve that the product gets into a economic biotope, into an economic process. And our idea was that we would give it to the people, this device, but they have to pay 10% of it. So in case we can make it for 300 euro, this would mean that they have to pay 30 euro. Now, in a developing country, obviously, again, 30 euro might be a lot of money. So the idea is that we finance the 30% with a microcredit. There are a lot of interesting organizations already out there offering microcredits, and the advantage is also that they are on site, they are in the country. So it means that the person who is using this has a local person he can talk to, and he has to pay back the 30 euro, I don't know, within 2 years. So he has a monthly installment of maybe 1 euro, and he can pay it back, and this works. And then we are in an economic cycle. We don't know what the people would do if they do have energy. There's a lot of speculation and funny discussion. I think that they will love to make cinema, or that they want to watch TV. Maybe they can extend their business-related capabilities, because for the first time they can solder, for example. They can build and do things that they probably were not able to build before. So, yeah, so this was basically the idea. It is, in my opinion, and as a creator, I'm not very proud about having this idea. The interesting part is, are we able to develop the idea? We are working on this. And finally, obviously, the question is, if you ask, what is all this effort good for? There are many, many, many reasons. Obviously, simply to give people the energy. I also mentioned that it would be very beneficial for people in industrialized nations. There's also one issue. I was a frequent traveler to Bhutan, which is a little kingdom in the Himalaya mountains. And the interesting thing the people told me there is that the young people go into the main city to get educated, and they get known to all the benefits of the modern world. And the problem is that they don't go back into the valley, because they even, they in Bhutan, many families, many places, they don't have running water, but they have also no power. And the young people who got attracted by the possibilities of the modern world, they don't go back, they don't want to miss this. So it's very crucial to also have energy suppliers in rural regions to keep the people there, and maybe they would then go back. So what I wanted to say is that this idea is doable. There's nothing, this is not rocket science. I mean, all the components are here. This is more like developing a smart new way of bringing this energy into the society. It only has to be done. Thank you. I would be happy if you join the project. Thank you.